patented one part process applies very strongly to LFP. We made a very strong bet in LFP. It's applicable to other battery materials, and we continue to work on that. But really, the big effort is on our on developing that. We have the pilot facilities in Quebec that we've spoken about. We have a licensing strategy with Worley. All of this perfectly positions us to address these new Chinese trade restrictions.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now, Dan Blondal. He is the CEO of Nano One Materials. And Dan, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Good to see you too, Steve. Happy New Year.
Yeah, Happy New Year to you as well. Thought it'd be a great opportunity to get you on to talk a little bit about something that was in the news recently. And this is the fact that China has proposed a ban on the export of in essence, battery cathode and lithium processing technology. So the ability to do things. And maybe let's start there. Kind of explain to everyone what this means and what this technology that now can't come anywhere but in China.
Yeah, well, you summed it up pretty well. It's an export ban on process technology, and that includes that doesn't just include sort of patents. It also includes know-how and learning, which is actually a massive part of the undertaking, and basically the industrial know-how to make these materials. And likely it will include equipment as well. The dust hasn't settled. It's a proposal. It won't be probably put into law for a couple months, but. It's fully expected. They do this kind of thing every year, so there's a strong pattern here that this will come into play. This one happens to be very specific to the preparation of lithium iron phosphate (LFP), LMFP, and various derivatives of LFP. All of its input materials, and that includes lithium iron, iron phosphate, phosphoric acid. And so, what they're really trying to do is restrict the learning outside of China and stall the proliferation of the technology that's been developed in China. It shouldn't be a surprise. Look, it's meant to protect and drive home China's dominance, their lead, their competitive advantage, all of that. Mm-hmm. And ultimately, I think it's a really strong signal. If the world hasn't already awoken to the strategic importance of LFP, then this is an alarm clock that should be shocking the West really out of its slumber. We've seen this coming for a long time. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when and who. LFP is going to be super important going forward. That's kind of the lay of the land. We obviously have a distinct advantage with the one pot process, and we can go into that in a little more detail.
Yeah, just on that, the knowledge part of it, I think is the key part of it, and holding back that knowledge part of it. And there are dominant players still in this, correct?
Very much so. So China has about 99% of the world's LFP market, and within their own boundaries, within their own borders, LFP is about 70. It's pushing well beyond 70% market share now. So it's a very dominant material. It's the cleanest, safest, longest lasting material, and the latest generation of LFP battery packs that are going into cars are comparable on energy density and range within the nickel based material. So what's not to love there? And that's why it's doing so well.
Yeah, so that puts us into a North American supply, and something that you know everyone has talked about, whether you're on this side of the border in Canada or in the United States as well. That's where Nano One really sort of steps up with the technology that you've been painstakingly creating over the last many number of years.
Yeah, so what we call our one pot process, our patented one pot process, applies very strongly to LFP. We made a very strong bet in LFP. It's applicable to other battery materials, and we continue to work on that. But really, the big effort is on our on developing that. We have the pilot facilities in Quebec that we've spoken about. We have a licensing strategy with Worley. All of this perfectly positions us to address these new Chinese trade restrictions, because we are homegrown, waste-free, we're fully decoupled from China's dirtier supply chains, and we're completely immune to China's trade and technology controls. And that puts us in a really unique position. Add to that our kind of design one, build many licensing strategy, because that provides a scalable, and actually this is really important, a really easy to permit plant that can be rapidly deployed into LFP manufacturing facilities to support the really the energy transition and to support large industrials and energy companies looking to unlock those supply chains.
And that, as I mentioned, not only in Canada, but also in the United States as well. And, you know, you obviously have an incoming president who has made a number of different statements. But in the end, the technology that you provide is something the U.S. is going to need. So can you talk to me a bit about what you expect, or can you understand what to expect quite yet?
Well, look, it's I think it's anybody's guess how things are going to play out at the end of January and in the next 6 months to a year. But I think one thing is for sure: secure supply chains is has bipartisan, multi-party interests with everybody right now, and so that plays very favorably into what we're doing, and plays very favorably into having a homegrown, localized technology that will be very good for Nano One, and this recent move by China only strengthens our position in that regard.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how it all shakes out. We'll be there to follow the story, of course. Dan, thanks so much. Really appreciate you taking the time to sort of address this and give some thoughts on where things are from Nano One's point of view. So appreciate it.
Thanks very much, Steve. Always great to talk to you. Look forward to the next.
All right, Dan Blondal, the CEO of Nano One Materials Corp.